Port Adelaide means the world to me. Well, it means the world to my family, and we bleed black and white at the Kale family, and it's all the generations through, and always has been that way and always will be. I was born on 2nd of October 1965. In fact, it was the grand final day when my dad was captaining Port Adelaide. I think I was born at about 1 p.m. He was at the ground already, Adelaide Oval back then. They were playing Sturt in the grand final, and we whacked him by 7 points. So we got over the line and won that one. But I played both tennis and footy up to about 16 years of age. I was a little bit better at tennis at that time, so I made a decision to concentrate more on tennis and kind of went from there. And I kind of got into tennis because my dad was a bit of a frustrated tennis player. He was a lefty serve and volley player, and he used to, when we'd come home from school, we had tennis courts just across the road from us, and he used to, come on, let's go out and hit a few balls. And that's actually how I got into tennis. The Williams family also, I grew up going over to Foss and Vaughn's place, and Mark and Stephen and Jenny and getting Anthony, getting involved with them on their grass court. As everybody will tell you, you need a little bit of a lucky break. And I got one with a famous coach in Bob Carmichael in Melbourne. I wasn't really good enough to go to the Institute of Sport where the best 10 kids were invited. But he saw a pretty good work ethic. For sure, I got that work ethic from the Port Adelaide Football Club, just hanging around the club, training, picking up balls during training when I'd go down there with Dad. And so I worked my butt off to be a tennis player, and he picked me as my best sporting moment and my worst sporting moment. Even though I've been lucky enough to coach some great tennis players, comes from the Port Adelaide Football Club. 76. And everybody that's a Port Adelaide supporter remembers 76 very well. 65,000 people at Footy Park wrapped around the oval when we lose to Sturt, and Bagshaw and Davies play out of their mind. And then the next year when we beat Glenelg in the grand final. By far my saddest moment, by far my happiest moment. Koshy took me out for a coffee in New York a couple of years ago and asked me whether or not I'd consider it at some stage. I said that I would love to. I was really honoured. But not only David, but also Cos Cardone was pretty instrumental in getting me onto the board. And with me travelling 35, 40 weeks of the year, I thought it was a bit difficult while I was doing the full-time coaching. And when I made the decision to take 2019 off and spend more time back in Adelaide, they asked the question again, and I gave it a week or two to have a good think about it and to talk to my family about it. My wife was pretty excited, I must say. My kids were very excited. So they gave the okay, and I gave the okay. I'm looking forward to it. I come in with eyes wide open. I don't know anything about a boardroom. It'll be the first time for me sitting with some incredibly smart people who have done some amazing things over the last 5 or 6 years and put Port Adelaide where it is today, in an incredible financial position. I think David sees me as a bit of a connection between the coaching group and also the board. And if I can do that and help everybody connect in a good way and hopefully be a bit of a an ear for the coaching group to talk to at times, and that would be great.